the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. Hello guys, today we will discuss in episode number 4 the types of sensors, which are defined as an electronic symbol devices that detect and convert the change in pressure, temperature, or mechanical movement into an electrical signal. There are 4 types of sensors: temperature, pressure, speed, and position. May I have your attention, please? So I hope that episode will help you to understand the sensor's functions. May you subscribe in my YouTube channel. Let's go and start the training.
Sensors are simple electronic devices that detect and convert a change in pressure, temperature, or mechanical movement into an electrical signal. There are 4 basic types of sensors: pressure, temperature, position, and speed. A pressure sensor measures changes in pressure and sends a variable DC signal voltage back to the ECM. Pressure sensors have 3 wires. The first wire supplies voltage from the ECM to the sensor, providing power for sensor operation. This supply voltage is precisely controlled to 5 plus or minus 0.5 volts. The second wire is a ground wire from the ECM to the sensor that provides a 0 volts reference. The third wire is a signal voltage from the sensor to the ECM. This signal voltage varies with changes in the pressure of whatever the sensor is monitoring. The operating range of the signal voltage is slightly greater than 0 volts and slightly less than 5 volts. A typical operating range for signal voltage is 0.5 to 4.5 volts. The ECM also determines if a sensor is shorted or open by monitoring the signal voltage. If the signal voltage is the same as supply voltage, the ECM knows the sensor or sensor circuit is open. If the signal voltage is 0, the ECM knows the sensor or sensor circuit is shorted. If the ECM senses either a short or an open circuit, it will indicate a fault for that circuit to assist in troubleshooting. The key pressure sensors on the engine are the boost pressure, atmospheric pressure, and oil pressure sensors. A temperature sensor measures temperature and uses only 2 wires. Temperature sensors change resistance as temperature changes. The ECM reads the resistance value and converts it to a temperature. The ECM determines if the temperature sensor is open or shorted by monitoring the resistance value. If there is a short, the resistance value is near 0. If the sensor circuit is open, the resistance value is very high. The important temperature sensors on the engine are the coolant temperature sensor, the intake air temperature sensor, and the fuel temperature sensor. The third type of sensor is a position sensor. An example of a position sensor is the accelerator pedal position sensor. This sensor monitors the position of the accelerator pedal and converts that position into a pulse width modulated signal that is sent back to the ECM. A position sensor has 3 wires. The first wire supplies voltage from the ECM to provide power for sensor operation. The supply voltage for the accelerator pedal position sensor is 8 plus or minus 0.5 volts. The second wire is a ground wire from the ECM to the sensor that provides a 0 volts reference to the sensor. The third wire is a signal voltage from the position sensor to the ECM. The accelerator pedal position sensor generates a pulse width modulated signal, which is a square wave. A square wave is either full voltage or 0 voltage, on or off. Duty cycle is the percent of on time. The duty cycle for the low idle accelerator pedal position is between 10 and 22%. Duty cycle at the high idle accelerator pedal position is 75 to 90%. The accelerator pedal position sensor transmits this duty cycle signal to the ECM at a constant frequency. This type of sensor provides a very accurate signal to the ECM with a smooth transition during acceleration and deceleration. The ECM determines if the accelerator pedal position sensor is faulty by monitoring the duty cycle. If the duty cycle is less than 5% or greater than 95%, the ECM will log an active fault. The fourth type of sensor is a speed sensor. The speed timing sensor has a permanent magnet and a coil of wire. A change in the magnetic field of the sensor induces a voltage into the sensor. The ECM reads the increase and decrease in voltage as a signal. As the camshaft gear rotates, signal teeth cast into the gear pass through the magnetic field of the speed timing sensor. The sensor generates a signal voltage as each timing tooth passes. The ECM counts the time between these signals to determine how fast the engine is running. All of the teeth are evenly spaced except one pair, which has an additional tooth between them. This additional tooth sends an additional signal, which indicates top dead center to the ECM. Because speed sensors use an internal magnet and coil to generate a signal voltage, they do not require a supply voltage from the ECM. They also use only two wires instead of the three wires used on pressure and position sensors. Newer engines use dual speed sensors, each with two wires. One is for the camshaft gear and the other is for the crankshaft gear. Older engines use a single three-wire speed sensor for the camshaft gear. On the dual sensor system, the camshaft gear is used to determine injector timing during engine startup. After starting, the crankshaft signal is used because it provides a more accurate and stable timing signal. With the new dual sensor system, if a sensor fails, the ECM will log an active fault and the engine will continue to run. With the older single sensor system, the engine will not run if the speed sensor fails. In review, four basic sensors govern engine operation: pressure, temperature, position, and speed sensors. The electronic systems on the engine may seem complicated. However, once you understand how these basic types of sensors work, the operation of individual circuits becomes much easier to understand.